On this edition of City Focus, the city honors Georgia Cities Week. We host one of our hotspot cleanup events. The Utilities Department is planning a fun event to teach citizens about the importance of water. There's still time to submit your entry for the People's Choice Photo Contest and meet the newest members of the Valdosta Police Department. These stories and more on this edition of City Focus. Welcome to City Focus. I'm Marcus McConico, the media coordinator for the City of Valdosta. This is the fifth episode of City Focus in 2022. City Focus is your source for what's happening within your government. Here are the most important topics that are happening in the city.
On May 7th, the City of Valdosta, in partnership with the Georgia Section American Water Works Association, is hosting No Water, No Beer Festival at Georgia Beer Company from 12 to 4 p.m.
This is more or less Drinking Water Week, so we're celebrating drinking water, recognizing the importance of clean drinking water. One good thing with this festival, it's a fundraiser mainly. Number one, we're raising funds for the organization Water for People.
The festival serves as a fundraiser for the nonprofit organization Water for People.
What they do is they go around in locations and places that are underserved with water, whether it be water or sewer, sanitation, they'll go out and provide the resources needed for that and to bring those communities up to speed.
Tickets for the festival can be bought through Eventbrite for $20.
If you want to join us for the festival, you can go through Eventbrite, order tickets online through them. Tickets up until April 23rd are $20 a piece. And with that $20, you get two free beers plus a t-shirt and a swag bag. So then after from April 24th to the event day, prices go up $25 a ticket. So
the festival marks the end of National Drinking Water Week and is a great way to bring awareness to the community about the need for clean water. The City of Valdosta's Utilities Department wants to give citizens tips on how they can identify if they have a leak. One is hearing the water in your toilet run.
Your toilets, make sure that the seals are tight and not loose, because 9 times out of 10 they can be loose and you don't know it. So therefore the water is draining out of the toilet, but the toilet tank itself has to stay full. So every time it drains down to a certain level, it's pushing water back in, meaning water coming through your meter, filling up the toilet bowl every few minutes is running.
Another thing to look out for is where there is a soft spot in the yard or a patch of grass that's greener than the rest of the yard.
Also look at your yard and see if you see like a greener spot than others, that means that you got a water leak. If you walk out there and it's mushy, you got a leak in the pipe. It can be a busted pipe. We recommend that you get a licensed plumber to take care of all of those needs.
The Utilities Department is always willing to check and offer advice to residents.
You suspect a leak outside, don't hesitate to call us, because we don't mind coming out, to investigate it, to make sure that it is something that we can help you with, or some, we can refer you to. And if we refer you to a plumber, a licensed plumber, that's what I recommend.
A change is coming to collecting recycling in the City of Valdosta. Glass products must now be separated from other recycling material.
The reason we're going to glass only is because the plant that takes our commingled material no longer can handle the glass material in their process, their sorting process.
The city's drop-off sites will have containers for just glass products. All other material can remain together. Since the creation of the drop sites, the city has seen a small increase in recyclables collected by the city.
So what we've asked everyone is that we've got these containers here to separate the glass from all the rest of the material. Everything else can be commingled. That'll be fine. We do have trailers set up over here for cardboard only, and now we've got the containers for glass only.
For information on where to find recycling drop-off sites, please visit the City of Valdosta's website.
If it's a number one, a number two, a five, or a seven, if you look, this is a number five. This is something we take.
The City of Valdosta's Public Works Department has had success with its recycling drop-off sites, but they want to avoid contamination in the bins.
The items that the city will take in as recyclable items. If you're not sure, there's several ways to find out. At each site that we have around town, there is a board posted up there, and it's a very colorful illustration of exactly what we have. And if you have internet access, you can go on the city's website.
Currently, the volume is close to the numbers produced using the curbside method. But when bins become contaminated, workers must separate recyclables by hand.
So with our three sites that we have, they have been working tremendously well. Everyone has been coming out utilizing the sites, and we've actually kind of picked up some of the volumes closely above what we were collecting, you know, curbside. And in doing this, we're starting to see a lot of contamination. People are dropping off items that's not recyclable.
The city encourages citizens to report offenders to Public Works. Avoiding contamination will allow more items to be recycled and not go into a landfill.
If you see something, report it. You know, see something, say something. If you see someone up there and they're throwing items in the recycle trailers that are not supposed to be there, you don't have to say anything to them. You know, please, if you can, we ask if you maybe just take a picture of a tag or car, some kind of description, and call Public Works, and then we'll get it to the proper channels.
For more information, contact Public Works.
South Georgia Medical Center is hosting a 3-hour trauma education training in its ER training room. The training was presented by Air Evac Life Team. The training covered topics such as burns, snake bites, and pediatric trauma. In the past, members of the Valdosta Fire Department, nurses, and EMS have been in attendance at the training. This event is a great way for our first responders to learn new skills and gain valuable information.
Every day that I come in, I know that the people that I work with are willing to do exactly for me what I would do for them. Other occupations, they have coworkers, we have partners, and that's for a reason. Fire!
Throughout my career, I've seen this department grow immensely over the years through training, personnel, equipment, and the volume of our calls. Our department now responds to more than 73,000 calls for service each year. Our department offers so many different paths for an officer to take as they navigate through their career at the Valdosta Police Department. We equip our officers with the best training, the best gear, and all the support they need to be successful.
I chose this department because my husband will be retiring here from the military, and so it just gave me an opportunity to start my career, and pay rate is higher than other departments. Benefits, the equipment that they provide, duty belt, vehicles, training throughout the year, it's great.
The reason I chose Valdosta Police Department is I was already in the area from working with the Air Force at Moody Air Force Base. After my enlistment was up, I got in contact with our IA lieutenant. She dropped the bug in my ear, said she'd think I'd be a good cop. And it just stuck with me. So I came and applied. They said they'd be happy to have me. I said I'd be happy to work for you.
Valdosta dispatch to 7139 and all available units. We have an active shooter situation at 206 39th Avenue. Have a barricaded subject with possible hostages.
As an accredited law enforcement agency, the Valdosta Police Department is always operating at the highest level of national law enforcement standards. We are always advancing and improving our capabilities.
One of the things that took me by surprise was the training I received at the Academy on mental health people. It's something that we don't think about, but you know, we encounter on a daily. And I feel like the training we receive really prepared me The best part about working as a police officer would be making an impact in people's lives. Helping victims get out of situations, provide them with resources available to them.
A lot of people say they have families in the workplace. A lot of people try to posture themselves as a family. But to me, a family is doing whatever's necessary, whatever cause, for whomever, that you call that family member. Being an officer is the closest thing to having an outside family as I can find. There's a moment that typically happens that lets me know I've done my job well. And that's when I arrest somebody, put them in the back of my police car, and then on the way to the jail, they thank me. They know that they've done wrong, and they respect the job that you've done. That typically is what makes me proud.
At the Valdosta Police Department, we will put our officers up against any in the country. We have great community involvement. Our officers are in the community every day, building great relationships, great partnerships, to work together to keep this community safe.
We take community policing to the next level. Our officers are constantly out in the community, whether it be crime prevention efforts, community events, or neighborhood walks aimed at meeting the residents of Valdosta.
There are many opportunities within the department to move around, meaning you do not have to stay as a patrolman. You can always move up.
There's so much experience that you'll get in your first few years here that will set you up for the other departments that we have in the PD, be it canine detective, narcotics detective, our power squad unit. That foundation is going to be built so early on because we have amazing supervisors from top to bottom. We make it our business to mold good cops because that's who's going to be watching our backs.
As we continue to see growth in our community and our region, the Valdosta Police Department continues to prepare and evolve into a regional response law enforcement agency.
We're so fortunate to live in a community that respects and takes pride in the work of our officers each day. We're proud to serve in the Valdosta community.
I'm so proud of the work that our officers do each and every day to put the Valdosta Police Department on the map. This department is truly second to none.
The City of Valdosta, in partnership with the Annette Howell Turner Center for the Arts, are proud to announce that the 14th annual Valdosta People's Choice Photo Contest is open for submissions.
We're so lucky to have a very strong city and county community. And so this is a really great opportunity for citizens to celebrate where they live. The really neat thing is to see the pictures that capture things that we either do not even know exist in our community, like those back road places that are beautiful and fabulous, but also the places that we drive by every day and don't even recognize their beauty.
This year's categories include City Life, Country Living, and People's Choice for Adult and Youth.
The beautiful part of this competition or this contest is that you don't have to be a photographer or professional to enter this. You can take it with your cell phone, any camera will do. The main thing is that you're capturing something in our community that's worth celebrating, which it's everything really. People, places, events, all those things that make our life wonderful here in the community. And then the city captures that onto a canvas and then we're able to celebrate it for 6 weeks in our galleries.
The deadline to enter the contest is May 20th, and the opening reception will be held on June 13th from 5 to 7 p.m., which will kick off voting that will run through July 13th. Winners will be announced at the awards reception on July 18th. The City of Valdosta hosted their spring semi-annual Love Where You Live cleanup event.
The goal is to try to get as much trash up off the streets as we possibly can, give the citizens the opportunity to get rid of household items such as furniture, appliances, clean out your storage buildings, clean out your garage, get rid of it. It's free of charge when we have these events, no matter how big the piles are.
Volunteers from the community and Valdosta State University all came out to support the City of Valdosta in keeping our community clean.
Awesome turnout with volunteers. We have a Japanese exchange student program that's here. There's 12, 15 of the exchange students here. They come out, they're doing an amazing job. They're excited, they're ready to do it again. We have a couple of sororities out, fraternities out. They're enjoying it. Had people just from the community coming out, members of Leadership Lounge. So we've had a great turnout this time.
If you missed this event, Public Works is hosting a river cleanup on May 7th, so be on the lookout for more information. The Valdosta Police Department held a swearing-in ceremony to welcome its newest members, Officers Dylan Boutwell, Chance Folsom, Luke Folsom, Daryl Michek, Kevin Town, and Lindsay Williams.
I've always wanted to be a public servant. I have always wanted to serve my community in different ways. My work history shows that. I've worked in nonprofits, I've worked in the church, I've worked in the hospital serving the community. And when we moved to Georgia, this was just a really new and exciting way to follow up on my education and serve the community further.
The new officers spent 3 months in the police academy and have built a strong bond.
It feels good after graduating the academy and everything. It was a long 3 months and just all the training and hard work, long hours that we put in. It feels good to finally be sworn in, and now I could finally serve the city.
It was really wonderful. I felt like as a group, the six of us together became closer, and we held one another accountable, and when one was having a rough day, the other was there. We really bonded as a team. And it was a really wonderful experience.
It was also a family affair at the ceremony, as officers Chance and Luke Folsom, who are cousins, joined the department, of which Luke's brother is already a member.
It's really good because I have family here working with me, and it makes the Valdosta Police Department seem even more like a family because I have my own blood here, and it's good because we could all help each other, and at the end of the day, we're all just one big team, so it's really nice.
The officers will begin their field training on May 2nd, so make sure to give them a warm welcome to the community.
The City of Valdosta is celebrating its first anniversary of its microtransit system, Valdosta On Demand.
It's truly hard to believe that 1 year ago today, we were standing here launching Valdosta's microtransit system. 65,100 rides later, here we are.
The program has been so successful that Valdosta has been used as a model for other cities and applauded by Georgia senators on Capitol Hill.
Valdosta always has, on a weekly basis, interested parties all over the world keying in on our metrics, keying in on this service. There are a lot of particular distinct features that we offer worldwide, whether it be Canada, Tokyo, Australia, Amsterdam, Sacramento, distinct features for each city. We very rarely have a city that combines multiple features in one, and Valdosta pushes that envelope.
The need for the service was underestimated, as many riders are using it to get to work and school.
To the council, I say thank you. You guys made this thing happen. 30 plus years of talking about it and finally got it to the finish line this time last year. 1 year later, it's a raging success. So thank you all.
We're celebrating our 1 year anniversary with Valdosta On Demand during Georgia Cities Week. So just a great day in Valdosta. But as you all know, you've heard me speak enough, it's always a great day in Valdosta, Georgia.
Download the Valdosta On Demand app today to schedule your ride.
The Department of Human Resources for the City of Valdosta held a health and benefit fair for employees of the city.
Health and wellness of all citizens is, critical to the City of Valdosta. But for our employees, they work so hard for us, and we want to make sure we give them an opportunity to meet partners in our community who are invested in the health and wellness of our employees.
The fair brought together more than 40 community partners who supply benefits to employees in different areas of health and wellness.
Health and wellness is not just about physical health. There's so much more to it. There's financial health, there's physical wellness, there's mental health. We've got folks here from Mary Kay and Avon, a couple of skincare. We want to look at the totality of the wellness for the person.
The City of Valdosta would like to thank all vendors who attended the fair to help educate our employees on how they can stay healthy.
As a part of Georgia Cities Week, Chief Boutwell and Chief Manahan participated in Coffees with the Chiefs at Good Coffee in downtown Valdosta.
We're down at Good Coffee downtown with Coffee with the Chiefs. We like to get out in the community and meet people and come out and have people talk to us and tell us any concerns or anything that's going on in the city that we can help them with.
They believe it's important to go out to the community to reach residents.
I think it's important that we come out into the community to see the citizens, to allow them to have questions. Some may be hesitant to call the station and ask for me to ask questions. Gives us opportunity to educate on what some of the things we have going on, some of the resources that we have here in the city.
They look forward to doing these types of events again in the future.
It's been great. This has been a great turnout. Probably one of the biggest ones that we've had in a while. Earlier we were on the radio with the mayor on his talk show, and we've seen a lot more people come out on this one.
We want to thank everyone that came out to the event. Pat Collins, Valdosta City Engineer, retired from the city at the end of April. During his 11 plus years at the city, Pat has headed countless projects to make the city better. Those projects include many road surfacing projects and new sidewalks. The department has also won numerous awards during his tenure, including the Smart Cities Award, where Valdosta was recognized in Barcelona, Spain. We thank Pat for all he has done for the city, and we wish him the best in his retirement. The city of Valdosta celebrated Georgia Cities Week during the last week of April. The week started with a proclamation being read at the customer service building. Throughout the week, the Valdosta Fire Department held several events, including a tour of Station 3 and taking out the fire safety house. The week also included the city's health fair for employees and retirees, and finally, coffee with the fire and police chief. We thank all city employees during Georgia Cities Week. Early in the show, we talked about the strategic summit and discussed some major projects coming to Valdosta. We asked citizens to become more engaged so they have more input with their local government. This concludes another edition of City Focus. Be sure to visit our website, valdostacity.com. Like us on Facebook, Valdosta, City Without Limits. Also join next door for city updates. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at City of Valdosta, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Metro 17 Valdosta, to watch City Focus on Demand. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time here on City Focus.